If you were listening, not Monday past, but the Monday before, we had the lads from Grosvenor Grammar School, and they were heading off to the Big Bang Young Scientists and Engineers competition. And wouldn't you just know it, the team impressed not just our listeners, but they also impressed the judges with their project Life Block, a way of sending aid to developing countries and to areas that have suffered from natural disasters. And here they are as winners in front of us this morning. Knox, David and Craig are all back this morning. Knox, let me start with you for those people who shamefully don't listen to this program every day and weren't listening last Monday. Tell us briefly about the project that you were taking away to this competition.
So we essentially realised the three problems in developing countries are housing, lack of food and water, and dealing with existing waste. So then we came up with a product that could solve all these in one go, and we essentially created a giant Lego brick that's filled with rice and water, and then it can be sent out, rice and water can be consumed, and then they can build houses out of it.
So, David, whenever you got there with this project and this entry for the competition, I mean, what were the levels of confidence? How were you feeling? Pretty good?
We're feeling quite good because we've been there before and we've sort of had a good bit of experience. We'd previously won Northern Ireland Young Engineers of the Year, and we're just really optimistic. We're hopefully going to come back with something.
So this was Birmingham, wasn't it, Craig?
Yep.
So you got there, was one of the first things to kind of try and suss out the opposition?
Yeah, well, there's so many projects there, it's hard to see them all, but there's some serious competition there. Some of the ideas are great, coming from all over the UK. So yeah, it's mad, some of the ideas people come up with.
So whenever you got in front of the judges then, Craig, what happened? What did you have to do?
So basically,
and who were they? Who were the judges?
So many questions.
This is big news, Karen. Best story of the morning.
They come from different companies who all sort of like sponsor the Big Bang Fair. They come round and we pretty much sort of deliver a bit of a 10-minute pitch to sort of explain all the problems that we were trying to solve, the Life Block, just bits about the Life Block and sort of how it could be marketed. And the future of it, really.
Did one of you do the pitch, or did you split it between the three of you?
It's all split up, really, so okay. We all just sort of take turns each and explain our parts, really.
So as you left the judges, David, had you a good feeling?
Some of the judges got straight away. Some of the judges sort of very dull, just sort of come over and just...
Poor school teachers, really, no.
You thought, oh dear, this isn't very good, but by the time I said to you, the faces have completely changed, and that's when we sort of knew.
Light bulb moment.
We'll have a chance here.
Yeah, we'll have a chance.
So what happens then, Knox? You do your presentation. How long did you have to wait, or what then happens until you find out?
So we'd had our judges on the Wednesday, wasn't it? And then we arrived there on Thursday morning, and we had our little envelope sitting there with with judges that and the sponsored prizes that we were going for. And we had three of them there, so we were very happy we were in. And
so what have you won? What do you get as a result of this?
So we won the Future Water Association's prize.
Uh-huh.
So we're hoping to meet up with a CEO to help like develop our Life Block, our product.
So this is part of the prize?
Yeah.
Excellent. So was this like a bit of work experience?
Sort of get to go and give a pitch at a conference that they're holding with NI Water. And
brilliant.
To meet up with the CEO and discuss sort of where the future of Life Block is and where we're going to go with it.
I mean, what would it mean to the three of you? And I know we're maybe getting ahead of ourselves, but I mean, if this product was to be produced and
commercially,
and you saw this sort of something tangible for all of this, not just competition wins, but you saw your product being used, what would that be like? That would be fantastic.
Yeah, it'd be a real sense of pride to sort of see, you know, a product we designed in school could actually have an impact in people's lives. You know, we've seen it, you know, it's been designed on computers, but to actually see it in the flesh, maybe, and to see how it's impacting those people's lives and making it a brighter future for them would be great.
So what's next for you three then, David? What are you going to do now? This is two competition wins, isn't it?
Well, hopefully we'll just see what happens with...
World domination.
We'll see what happens with the Future Water Associations and take it from there and see if there's possibly a chance of putting an introduction.
What was the reaction at school whenever you were able to come back from Birmingham and tell everybody what happened?
When we're just walking around, like, the teacher's just congratulating you, and even now...
Autographs, photographs, selfies.
Even now, and I was just going to fill up my water bottle, just teachers are saying, well done, just be proud of yourself. So,
what do you all want to do? Where do you all want to go next? What age are you all?
I'm 14, these two 15.
Right, so what's the future hold for Knox?
I'm thinking something maritime, hopefully.
Right.
Engineering.
David?
Probably agricultural engineering, something agricultural.
Mm-hmm. And Craig?
Probably some sort of civil engineering or something along those lines.
Right.
Engineering's a strong feature. What about your teacher? Does he get any credit or she get any credit for all this?
Yeah, well, they've put a lot of work into sort of supporting us, you know, taking us to all these events, so you have to thank them a lot. You know, without their help, you know, we wouldn't be here.
Yeah.
Brilliant, all these days out of class.
Yeah. Were they well behaved at the awards party?
Yeah.
you got a cash prize as well, didn't you? Did you get to keep it?
Yeah, we got £500 split between us, so.
Brilliant.
What are you buying?
We'll buy a few more cars.
Do you need a calculator to divide that and work it out? Are you able to do that in your head? Because we've been asking our listeners that on the program this morning, because there's this research that suggests that actually having a calculator in the classroom helps you. You know, the way a lot of people used to say, oh, you shouldn't have the calculator, you should have to work it out
mental
for yourselves.
Arithmetic.
Mental arithmetic. Well, what do you all bring your calculators in, do you?
Yeah, well, depends what you're really doing in class. So, like ratios and all of that stuff, you can't need them.
But you could divide £500, David, by three, could you? Can you
yep.
Say, yeah.
And make
sure the advantage fell your way.
£166.66.
You'll not fleece that man for a car, will you?
There'll be no bargains in that yard, I don't think. Not too many, anyway.
Listen, lads, well done. Good to see you all again. Thanks
very
for coming
well.
In. Enjoy your Easter holidays and make sure that figure's right, because I think David would try to con you.
Knock
David and Craig from Grosvenor Grammar, another big win for them. Well
a pleasure,
done.
Well done. Great, I will follow your careers with interest. Any more prizes or awards, do let us know. We'll have you back in the show. Great to have you here.